Good evening. Welcome on into another episode of From Day One. Along with a new person to our channel, Dunning Kruger, we start off a new sovereign citizen, and we basically will take about an 8-month life trek with him starting in January of 2023. As you start in court.
Do I have a current phone number?
For a little added context before we continue, his court date was rescheduled because of an emergency with the prosecutor. They attempted to call him for a few days to no avail. That's why the clerk is asking about an updated phone number.
Okay, my time is important.
He's not here to help you.
Oh, sorry, he's not here to help me?
That's what happened is
is a judge here? I'm here on special appearances. Is a judge here? Special appearances. Is a judge here?
Speak
with me.
No matter how special his appearance was, the judge was not available.
Okay, well, I'm not coming back.
Enjoy your failure.
$20,000 for me to show up, and it's going to be $10,000 every 15 minutes past that.
You'll just go and get arrested.
Okay, like I said, this is wasting my time.
Okay, great, thank you.
It's always curious to me where they come up with their fee schedule numbers. They're always different. Do they pull them out of their ass along with their case law?
Yes, I guess.
He even went so far as to let his audience know that the court clerk, who totally has authority over the city budget, agreed to his fee. I do hope he spends it wisely.
Actually, I do have a question. To file a motion for abandonment, do I do it through y'all? Yes. Okay. I'll file motions through y'all to go to the district attorney or whoever is trying to has a claim against me. I was here because I was traveling and I was pulled over, and the officer wrote me citations.
Okay. So you did the.
Oh, you're an idiot.
If you don't know it, then it's kind of hard to explain. It's just a motion to get the case dismissed.
A motion for abandonment typically refers to a legal request made to a court to dismiss or terminate a case due to the apparent lack of interest by the plaintiff. In this case, having to continue the case because of an emergency certainly doesn't mean there's no interest in continuing the prosecution, as he will learn a couple of months later.
So we move ahead. March.
It's a personal vehicle. I'm traveling.
I'm sorry?
There is a license plate.
You supposed to be out of Texas, or?
I'm sorry?
Can you roll down your window for me, please?
No, I'm good. You can step forward a little bit.
I don't know what's in the back. Can you roll the back window for me?
No, sir.
You got a super tinted window, sir. I can't see inside.
Well, it's that a...
Yes.
I mean...
Super tinted window? Yeah, it is.
The back? No, I don't think so.
Okay. Yes, sir.
I'm traveling?
No, you're not.
No, sir. So this is your feet to hand stop for
a traffic stop? Is that a crime?
Yes, sir. You did a traffic violation out of the transportation code, sir.
Is that a commerce?
Not signaling your turn prior.
I think I did signal.
No, sir.
I don't care.
Okay, well.
Do you have your license and insurance, please?
Do I need it?
Yes.
I'm asking for it at this time.
I'm traveling.
I don't care.
Commerce right now. If you read it, says not for hire.
I don't care if you're not for
blaming. I'm not under commerce right now.
Yeah, officer, did you not read his completely legitimate sticker he smacked onto the back of his truck that says, quote, not for hire, or his even more legitimate plates that read, quote, private? The only people I see benefiting from all this nonsense are those that sell these license plates. And maybe the sticker manufacturer.
Can you step out of the car for me, sir?
Is there a reason?
Yes.
I told you to.
Multiple times? You haven't given it
multiple times? I think you asked me once.
Sorry?
You asked me once.
I've asked you twice, sir.
Oh, twice? I'm going to ask twice.
Usually I ask, then I tell you, and then I'm going to ask you to step out now.
Okay, so you're ordering me, or are you asking me?
I'm going to order you.
Are you asking me, or are you ordering me? Up.
Show me your driver's license. You have one? Is that a requirement? You have a driver's license. Are you ordering? ordering me to do a thing.
After getting through the ordering slash asking saga, he does eventually exit the vehicle.
I'm not under that commercial right now.
What do you mean you're under that commercial?
Commercial, I'm not. Operation is a commercial term. I'm not operating, I'm traveling. This vehicle has been deemed by the United States Supreme Court that it's personal property and it's considered to be household goods.
No. No, it isn't.
You can look up. You can look up Chicago.
What's your first name, sir?
Vaughn.
Yes, sir. So, like I said, you committed two traffic violations.
Is that a violation or is that a criminal? I'm going to tell you right now. Do you know what a national is? You don't know what a state national is, and you're an officer. Do you know what a state national is?
Yes, it's you being a moron.
Ooh, officer, let me take this one. You see, American state nationals use their completely fake status as a way to assert their sovereignty and separate themselves from the jurisdiction of the federal government. They believe that by claiming this absurd status, they are not subject to certain laws, regulations, or obligations imposed by the government. But to simplify things even more, it's basically playing dress-up, but for adults.
Do you have your thing covered up? I don't know, is it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do you remember, where do you live? Do you live in Texas? Do you live in...
I'm
not domiciled. I don't reside nowhere. I'm not answering that question.
Okay. He lives in Fantasy Land, officer, which unfortunately you don't have jurisdiction over.
You know what, they're driving legal with the data, right? They didn't teach you definitions of driving. Driving's a commercial term. Operating's a commercial term as well. I'm not operating, and I'm not... I'm traveling in my personal conveyance.
He's traveling in his own dick.
You have a triple vehicle?
No, he's still
there. That'd be just against Mandatory law. And you read what's on the back of the tailgate, right? It says not for hire.
No,
I didn't. Did you read that? You don't read that?
Not
for hire. That means I'm not
for her.
Operating commercially. Statutes and codes is for commercial. It's for y'all, not for... You understand now?
Yeah, I think he totally understands now. About as well as the supervisor that's about to arrive on scene.
Hi, sir, how are you?
Good, all right.
I'm going to officer court. The supervisor and the sergeant's also on his way, but... I guess there's a misunderstanding. I guess he pulled you over for various violations. There's some kind of...
So he claims. I guess there was an emergency.
An emergency? Over there.
Well, he turned his lights off.
Go ahead and tell him what you did.
That's considered an emergency.
So as police officer in Texas, yes, sir, whenever there's a traffic violation, we have the authority to pull the vehicle over and address the
traffic violation. Go over blue lights.
Yes,
come on. Vasquez, and what was your number again?
1221.
1221.
Yes, sir. So as far as the traffic stop, obviously you are detained right for the violation. You're obligated to provide your driver's license if you're a driver.
I'm not driving.
Okay. I understand you have your opinions of traveling and stuff, and operating and not operating.
Can you look up section 50.02.
We can also look up the Texas traffic code.
Yeah, that's Texas traffic code. 50.02. You can look up that one.
How about we look up the traffic code? You're required to present your driver's license when pulled over and offered by an officer.
Is that driver? You know the definition of driver?
Yes,
yeah,
you.
No,
but I'm asking you to understand the definition of driver. Because this could be bad for you.
Hear me out, okay? What was your name again, sir? I'm sorry.
I didn't have you.
That's
not an opinion. The Supreme Court. Do you believe in the Supreme Court? So you think I should just bow down to you, get on my knees, and suck your and bend over and...
Easy there, big fella.
Yeah,
we aren't talking about your bedroom etiquette here. Stay on topic.
Do you understand?
No, we do not keep
Black Law's Dictionary, because that's what the Supreme Court uses in all
no,
the
No, 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 we don't.
And look up the word drop.
Well, that's simply not true. Judges typically do not rely on a specific dictionary as a primary source for legal definitions.
Correct.
Instead, they interpret and apply the law based on legal statutes, prior court decisions,
Correct.
Legal principles,
Correct.
And legal reasoning.
That's
While not the sole
you,
source,
Mr.
judges do sometimes consult legal dictionaries to get a general understanding of a term or phrase. Saying that, The judge in my favorite case of all time, U.S. versus Cardigan, used the Merriam-Webster dictionary to define the term lobby.
I'm just going to let this corporal talk because he's going to
love from the Merriam-Webster.
Get yourself in control.
We're trying to be respectful. I'm trying to be respectful
to you too. I'm giving you ruling, right?
But I'm also trying to get you
to understand that. I understand. I understand.
If
you want to arrest me, I'll give you everything you want.
Okay, perfect. Awesome.
Oh, what was that? Come on, man. Fight for your freedom.
How long has this been? 16 minutes. Y'all know y'all have like 4 minutes, right?
Sorry?
Y'all have like 4 minutes to wrap this up to make a decision, right? You know what I mean?
Well, it sounds like they're trying to do that.
You know, Supreme Court's rule, 15, 20 minutes is reasonable.
It's reasonable.
Anything over that, you know, it's...
Depending on the circumstances, sir.
No, they didn't say depending on the circumstances.
Yes, you know.
The traffic stop, which is just...
Especially when you're trying to milk the clock.
In fairness, yes, the Supreme Court has issued rulings on the duration of traffic stops and the permissible length of time for such stops because they are considered temporary detainments. Knowing that this man is a big follower of Chile de Castro, he may be referring to one of the cases de Castro continues to bastardize Rodriguez versus the U.S.
In that case,
the court held that a traffic stop may not be prolonged beyond the time reasonably required to address the initial reason for the stop, such as issuing a citation or conducting routine checks related to the traffic violation. Given the fact that our traveler has yet to produce his driver's license, insurance, or registration means they are still addressing the initial reasoning for the stop, you don't just get to filibuster your way out of it.
Thank you.
All right, sir. So, I'd like to give you one last chance to is a sergeant here? He don't want to talk to
me. He is, but I'm supposed
to talk to you. Oh, the sergeant don't want to talk to me? I prefer talking to him.
So this is my traffic stop. So,
if I don't, will I be arrested?
Please do.
I will be arrested. Okay, I'll go ahead and give you my number.
Sure.
I'll go ahead and give you my stuff. Sit. He did say he would arrest me if I didn't give him my information.
All right, what's your information, sir?
His brain legit froze for a few seconds there. He couldn't quite figure out how to give his information verbally to the officer while live streaming. He finally muted his stream, because of course, and told the officer his license number. So much for freedom.
Yep.
It's now been 24 minutes. They've actually gone past the time. Hey, I'm from here on out, it's $1,000. A minute from
your stand here. Oh, you want to make
damn, me. In the span of just a couple of months, his price has increased from $667 a minute to $1,000 a minute. I guess inflation even affects American state nationals.
$1,000 a minute for me to stand here and charge charging the city to that. You okay with that?
Oh, fuck off.
Your municipal... I'm telling you right now, it's $1,000 a minute for me to stand here from now on. Making contract with us, because this is what this is. This is a contract. I'm not willing to contract with them. But I'm also putting them on contract. I'm $1,000 a minute to stand here.
Yeah, you do.
Let's see what's going on. Hey, Connor, there. Go ahead and arrest me.
Can
I ask him why I'm getting arrested?
So, as it turns out, he didn't return to court after the cancellation we covered earlier. Oops. I wonder if he got his money. After his arrest and a night in jail, he goes to a different court to inquire about his new citations he received from his latest stop.
So, back to court we go.
Have the option of paying in full the $272, or do you want a payment plan? That would be a
I'm
not here to make a payment arrangements.
Okay. If you want it off your record, there's the option of defense attorney. If you have not taken a course in a year.
Well, I'm not here to say that I'm guilty of all these charges.
Okay. So how do you want to
take it? Well, I can't make a plea without seeing all the evidence.
Okay. There is an option if you want to speak to the prosecutor and court.
I'll need your signature for the notice to promise to appear, and then you will also get a copy of what you signed.
They want me to sign. So,
I absolutely love the way he signed for this paperwork. UCC 1-308 is often referred to as the reservation of rights provision, which will surely get him out of this predicament.
Yep, have a good one.
Always.
You know, unfortunately, I wish I could say the same to him, but I could give a care less about him if he wanted in fucking hell.
Hey, nice job, knock it off.
The absolute nerve of that tyrant to say, take care, sir. Unbelievable.
Anyway, I want to show y'all that I'm at the courthouse. And I do practice what I preach. When I do right to travel, even though I'm at the courthouse and I've been followed by College Station cops for the past week, I will not give in. We have to stand up and fight for our freedoms. And because they throw me in jail one night, doesn't mean I'm going to stop.
And stop he doesn't, because, well, roll that tape.
Wow. That much later.
This is what I'm fixing behind him. Is there an emergency?
No, sir. You're driving a truck that does not have valid license plates on it.
Don't need it.
Okay. Do you have your driver's license proof?
I'm not waiving any of my rights. I want to go ahead and hand you this.
Okay. Just so you know, my name is Officer Lightfoot with the College Station Police Department, okay?
Okay.
You stopped just for the plate.
You might want to call CAPS. Go ahead and hand you that.
What is this, sir?
You can read it. Kari, I presume you can read?
No.
Is there no emergency?
Oh, you're being stopped for a traffic violation.
Okay, you might want to call your supervisor.
Okay, he's on the way. Can you step out of the truck for me?
What's your probable cause for me stepping out of the truck?
You're under arrest.
I'm under arrest for what?
For the traffic violations, because you've been warned about this and cited for it.
I went to court on this.
Step out of the truck, please.
I would prefer your supervisor. I prefer your supervisor get out here.
Can you start this way? He's refusing to get out of the truck. Can you please get out of the truck, sir?
Wait for your supervisor.
Can you please get out of the truck?
I'll wait for your supervisor. So were you waiting on me?
Policeman.
Sorry? I said y'all been waiting on me?
No, I saw you pulling out from
y'all been waiting on me.
I saw
y'all been stalking me.
And
y'all been stalking me.
I recognize your truck.
How do you recognize my truck?
Because it's got the private tags on it.
Oh, so you're stalking me.
No, I was driving down the road and then I made a U-turn because I saw you turn.
Okay, you don't want to fill this out?
No, why would I fuck with that?
No, I want you to fill this out. You have to fill this out by law.
No,
so this is the questionnaire that he provided, which asks, amongst other things, the police officer's home address.
Okay. Supreme Court has also ruled that, I'm going to go ahead and give you this, too. Let me show you what I'm giving them.
Okay, I'll take it. Just hang on to it for now. Okay?
Yeah, I want you to read it.
We're waiting for my supervisor, right?
Okay, yep. You can go ahead and read this, too.
Okay, just hang on to it for now, sir.
This guy tries to hand him so many pages of Sov Cit nonsense that it would fill up Homer's Odyssey.
Is there a reason why you don't want to just get out of the vehicle and talk to me?
Because you got a gun. You're holding your hand on your gun.
Just resting my hand.
Yeah, because now you already said I'm under arrest and you're asking me questions, so I'll go ahead and plead my Fifth Amendment.
Are you resisting arrest?
No, I'm not resisting arrest.
Okay.
I want to know why I'm under arrest. Why am I under arrest?
For the track violation.
That's an arrestable offense.
You have been cited.
Yeah, in the court.
Time for those, which means that the citations are not working. It is arrestable.
No. Have I been to court?
I'm sorry?
Have I been to court?
I don't know what you're referring to, sir.
Oh, you don't know what I'm referring to? Okay.
I don't know the point of your question.
Okay. The court decides that, right?
This reasoning here is just chef's kiss. It's like saying, officer, I know I just robbed this bank, and I know that I was previously arrested for robbing a different bank. However, that case is yet to be adjudicated. Ergo, Bank of America, here I come.
Yeah, but I'm doing a constitutionally protected activity. Constitutionally protected activity.
What are you talking about? Driving? No, I'm not driving. I'm traveling.
Okay, I got you.
So you want to read this? No. Like I said, once I'm able to do that and I'm able to do that safely, I will do that.
Okay. They were waiting on me, stalking me again.
You saw me driving down the road and I recognize your truck. I recognize your truck because you do it, you drive around and you've been told multiple times it's not legal.
So, not legal? It is legal, 100%. No, I don't. No, I don't. But if you read this, you would understand, maybe. Once again, I'm going to try to hand it to him.
Go ahead and put that back in the car. I've already told you.
Do you want to read this?
Nobody wants to read this.
I don't need to read that right now. I just need you to step out of the vehicle for me.
Is your supervisor here?
He's on his bike.
Okay, I'll wait for your supervisor.
No,
once again, another vehicle just pulled up.
I believe that's my supervisor there.
Okay.
Hello.
Yep. Name and badge number?
Corporal Carpenter.
I know. I've met you before. Oh, yeah.
Sorry, I can't hear you.
I've met you before.
What's that?
I said I've met you before.
Okay. So what's going on today? They said you wanted a supervisor.
Yes. He says I'm under arrest for traveling.
I believe he said you were under arrest for, was it no registration and no...
And no license, but the things you've been cited for multiple times.
Yeah, and I went to court, and the judge hasn't decided if I can or can't yet.
Okay.
Spoiler alert, you can't.
So you might want to read these. These are case laws.
Okay.
Will you take a minute to read these?
Okay. So you're under arrest.
Okay.
So we need to
for under arrest for driving for traveling down the roadway.
Correct.
Do you have a supervisor?
No, I don't.
You don't have a sergeant because you're just a corporal. Is there a lieutenant or somebody with brass?
No lieutenants here tonight.
There's no lieutenants here tonight.
No, sir.
Okay, you know I'm having a meeting with your chief, right?
Okay.
You don't care about that either? To be discussing this because y'all been...
I'm not sure what that has to do with this situation.
This situation because this is constitutionally protected activity.
No, okay. It's not.
So, you're under arrest for the charges that we said. If you don't step out of the vehicle, you're going to be additionally charged with interference.
Interference, sorry.
Yes.
Well, I'm gonna turn my truck on so I can roll up my windows.
Interference.
No, don't do that, Mr. Fine.
I'm just going to roll up my windows.
After the fact.
What's that?
We'll turn your windows up after the fact.
After the fact.
You can do it with the door open so that way we know that you're not going to take off on it.
That's what I'm doing. I'm not cranking it on.
Finally have a moment of clarity there at the end. After months of this nonsense, 3 arrests, thousands of dollars in fines, he finally lets out a, oh, fuck, man. I really think that sums it up nicely for our American State National, because all he's really done is F himself, all in the name of freedom. All right, everyone, thanks for coming by today.
Aww.
If you want to see similar content in the future, please consider subscribing, notifying, liking, and...
Thank you very much. We definitely appreciate you. And with that... That'll bring us to a close for the night as well. Please make sure you do like, share, and subscribe. Help us get to that goal of 50,000 views, which we're on the cusp. We just need to push over so we can get those red presents from Boxy to send to all of you and Google to put us on the algorithms. Coinbase, Ibotta, game.gg, of course, are around. Make sure you do get your freebies from them. New sponsor coming probably either tomorrow or Monday. So stay tuned for that as well. And until next time, like, share, and subscribe again to one another, and release the Krakens. As we march along this evening and every evening here from day one. Have a great night. We'll see you tomorrow.